So, gentlemen of the jury, honorable audience, it's my pleasure today to share with you an overview of my research activities since 2010 to today, and with the title of given by mathematical optimization methods for NFV as network functions virtualization and cloud resource allocation problems. But before going into the details of this presentation, of course, please let me introduce to you the overview of my scientific backgrounds, my achievements, my involvements in different research and development projects. So at the end of 2005, I obtained my master in operations research at Paris Dauphine University. And then I started my PhD thesis jointly with Paris 6 University and Telecom Sud Paris. So I defended my PhD thesis at the end of 2009. And during this period, I gained some experience in different and very promising research areas such as combinatorial optimization, essentially graph theory, linear algebra, etc. And after the defense of my PhD thesis, I joined Telecom Sud Paris in another department of research as a research engineer or a postdoc. So my role in this position consists finally to I was very actively involved in different research and development projects about cloud computing problems, pricing in the cloud, resource allocation problems in the cloud computing. And after 3 years at Telecom Sud Paris, I joined, and after a small spell in cloud computing SME in Paris, I joined SystemX as a researcher at the end of 2013. And my role in SystemX consists to finally make research and development projects with industrial partners and academic researchers in the same collaboration. So I was involved in making R&D projects on cloud computing, OpenStack environments, network functions virtualization, SDN, 5G networks, etc. In parallel to these activities, I proposed various courses. So I will have also some teaching activities on combinatorial optimization, mathematical programming, etc. And in parallel to these activities, I was also involved in approximately 8 research and development projects with industrial partners such as Orange, Nokia, and others. And also I collaborated with more than 13 researchers. So this allowed to me to finally mentoring or supervising 6 PhD students. Actually, some of them they already defended their PhD thesis. And I filled off 3 patents and published more than 50 papers. And recently I joined also the scientific direction of IRT SystemX as the head of networks and infrastructure research team. So after this brief introduction, please let me now go to the details of this presentation. I chose it to finally discuss 3 research topics in general. The first research topic concerns the placement and the repacking of resources. And these resources are often represented by virtual machines. So we would like to find optimal solutions for the repacking of these virtual machines in a cloud data center. So we consider requests represented as independent nodes. Each virtual machine for here is a node. And then we will address another problem which generalizes the first problem, in which we would like to consider interconnected nodes, so interconnected virtual machines, to be placed in a larger graph, which is the graph of the cloud or cloud federation of, for example, K-involved cloud providers. So the problem is much more complex than the first one. And the third research topic will address another problem in the NFV area or domain on which I would like to consider requests as directed graphs. So connected virtualized network functions with another constraint, which is the sequencement between each couple of virtualized network functions. And we would like to find an optimal mapping on a larger graph, which is the physical substrate graph, on which we would like to map these requests. Now, let me give more details on the first research topic, on the virtualization, the repacking problem of virtual machines in a cloud data center. So we would like, as a cloud provider, to enhance and improve the total revenues of when offering, for example, here, IaaS services. So if we proved in some research activities that a smart placement, actually, of these virtual machines is not a no, and we would like, and after some departures of virtual machines actually placed on the cloud data center, we get some servers underused. So we would like to make some consolidation of the physical infrastructure to reduce, for example, the total number of used of the physical servers that should be used to host these virtual machines. And then finally, this consists to optimize the energy consumption, reduce the total number of servers, reduce the operational cost, etc. So this is the idea. And before going into more details, let me define in this context an SLA violation. So in this context, in our work, an SLA violation is represented by simply the percentage of overused servers. And according to this definition, finally, the focus of this first research topic consists to define online placement solutions to handle with NPR problems and find finally optimal solutions, or in the worst case, near optimal solutions for this problem, when minimizing at the same time the SLA violation. If you would like to give more details, so we consider a certain number of available physical servers to host virtual machines. So we suppose that actually we have some virtual machines are actually instantiated in these physical servers, and we would like to find how to make a repacking solution and when reducing the total number of used servers and when also meeting the SLA violation. Before detailing the solutions that will be investigated and proposed in this work, if we would like to take a look very quickly to the complexity of the problem. So if we represent in our case that each virtual machine as an item and each physical server as a bin, so we can find very quickly similarities with the well-known NPR problem, which is the bin packing problem. So we deduce easily that our problem in this case also is NPR. And that's why we would like to tackle this kind of problems, this kind of NPR problems, to find optimal solution or near optimal solutions in negligible times, even for large problem instances. That's the idea of the contribution concerning this first research topic. So, as a first algorithm or a first approach to cope with this NPR problem, we consider two cases, very simple cases here, on which actually we consider the virtual machine I is actually hosted by server K. So we define, here we try to construct a bipartite graph step by step. So if this virtual machine I is actually hosted by server K, so we define an arc between a node that should be generalized here and showed clearly here, between this node, virtual machine I, and the server K, with only the weight on this arc, which is equal to the hosting cost represented by H, I, K. I for the virtual machine and K for the physical server. The other case consists to say that if the virtual machine I is actually on server K prime, for example, and our optimization recommends us to migrate this virtual machine I for server K prime to another server K, so we have to consider, in addition to the hosting cost, we have to consider reconfiguration cost. For example, the reconfiguration cost should be, for example, equal to the migration cost. Now, according to these two cases, we generalize this idea to construct a bipartite graph very, very quickly. And the first part of this bipartite graph considers only virtual machines, the second one only available physical servers to host these virtual machines, and the arcs will be constructed as it is detailed above. And on this bipartite graph, we have just to compute a B matching solution. So the idea consists to find, starting from an NP-hard problem, which is very similar to the bin packing problem, find a linear reduction to a well-known polynomial problem that should be solved in a few seconds, even for large problem instances. So this is the idea. And it's well-known that the B matching algorithm is solvable in polynomial time. That's the idea of this approach. So we have the proposition, the following proposition, to say that B matching, just to record it very quickly, is a generalization of the matching approach, or one matching approach. So a matching consists simply to find a set of edges that cover all the set of nodes with exactly one edge or one arc. That's what we say, one matching, or simply matching. We generalize this idea by proposing B matching, such as B is a vector of all the nodes, such that if V is a virtual machine, we would like to cover it by only one edge. That's why we put here one. And if V is a server, a physical server, so we propose this formulation to say that this physical server can, for example, have more than 1 degree at this solution. So by applying this proposition, we use the convex Hull, or the mathematical formulation of the B-matching approach, by adding some modifications, of course, in the objective functions, finally to clearly define similarities between the B-matching problem and our problem that we should to solve. And the result will be explained at the end of this first topic. As we have some SLA constraints to be met, we would like to propose another solution to take into account or to find solutions that converge very quickly and when reducing the SLA violations. That's why, if we consider a feasible solution of our problem, so we can just say that in this example, we have three virtual machines that should be repacking within using three physical servers. So this is, in graph theory, a solution for our problem. Virtual machine one will be hosted in this server, et cetera, et cetera. So if we take a look to this representation, to this graph, so it is simply a forest of trees. Okay? And if we relax the physical service limited constraints, so we find this definition, we would like to find finally as a solution of our problem, just a forest of trees with a minimum weight. And when we take a look to the literature, so we found that this is a matroid according to these definitions. And the proof, you can find it in the manuscript. So we proved that if we put F like that, so we have a matroid which is well known as a graphic matroid. So this is another way to solve efficiently our problem. And it's like, just for clarification, matroid theory, it's like dynamic programming approaches, integer linear programming approaches, use it to find optimal solutions of NP-hard problems. So here we use the matroid, the graphic matroid, to find solutions, and the results, the simulation result of this approach will be also detailed in the sequel. If we have a graphic matroid, of course, we can deduce very easily a greedy algorithm. which is detailed here. Now, if we would like to assess the performance of our algorithms by using some metrics, for example here, of course, the execution time, which is the necessary time to converge to the optimal solution. So we have in this column the beam matching approach, the beam packing algorithm, the greedy based on the graphic matroid, and we also add, as it can be noted in the literature, that the best fit algorithm is really a solution which is very often used. So we would like to just to take and to compare also with according to other heuristics, but in my mind, it's sufficient to compare to the optimal solution. So we take different scenarios, and I would like to take a few seconds, if you allow me, to the worst case of our simulation, which consists, which considers 3,000 virtual machines to be repacked in a physical service in a data center with 700, for example, physical servers. So the result here, or the execution time, the necessary convergence time here for this algorithm is approximately 2 seconds for this case. And without any surprise, the simplex solver used to solve the branch and bound algorithm exceeds 4 hours to reach the optimal solution for this kind of instance. And the matroid solution can converge to a solution. We don't know if it's optimal or no, but I have another simulation to show to you. In 355 seconds, and the best fit solution is 7 seconds, which is very, very rapid. Now, this assessment of the execution time is not enough to get more information about the quality of the algorithms we proposed. The beam matching one and the greedy ones. That's why we would like to here evaluate the cost evolution or the cost found by the four algorithms. So the red line or the red curve is the optimal solution found by the beam packing approach. The black one is the beam packing solution. So if we observe the comparison to between these two curves, so for number of available servers exceeding approximately 120 servers, we find exactly the same solution. It means that the bin packing found always, for these cases, the optimal solution. Okay, but if we take a look to this this part, considering approximately number of available servers between 80 and 120, for example, we have the cost of the bin packing lower than the optimal solution, which is not normal. So this is simply can be explained by the fact that the beam matching algorithm has some SLA violations. That's why the cost of the beam matching algorithm is lower than the optimal solution. So we get some SLA violations here. That's why also we would like to propose the another solution based on matroid theory. And remember that concerning the matroid, we said that under this condition, which is very strong, if we relax the service limited capacity, so we have an optimal solution of our problem. This is confirmed by this curve. If we relax, so by taking finally into account very larger servers in the cloud data center, so we found that the curve of the greedy solution is converging to the optimal one. And we can note also that the best fit is we put it here just to make some comparisons, and it can converge very quickly, but the quality of the solution is not better than the two other approaches. Now, there is also another criteria which is very important here, which consists to evaluate the SLA violations for our algorithms. So we noted that here we can found that the three algorithms except the beam matching one have zero violations in terms of percentage, and the beam packing is starting violations from 7%, firstly, and then this percentage of SLA violation is decreasing and will be close to zero when we consider large physical data centers in our case. So that's the three metrics I chose it here to discuss. But in the paper, you can find more results. I would like to conclude this first part by considering, finally, to summarize very quickly that the beam matching is a very efficient solution. converge very quickly compared to the others one. And when we consider scalability issues, finally, in our problem, so the bin packing is has no SLA violations and can converge to optimal solutions. So this is the first contribution. We would like, as an ongoing extension to our work, to include, when we repack solutions, to include some constraints based on affinity and anti-affinity constraints between virtual machines. And of course, this is work with some PhD students, and some of them, they already defended their PhD thesis. Now, I would like to go to the second topic, which in which we would like to generalize the request of end users by taking, instead of considering independent virtual machines, we would like to connect them to finally construct end-directed graph to be placed on a larger graph. And here, we would like to consider the larger graph as the graph of a cloud federation on which we have K cloud providers involved in the same federation to share some resources. And we would like also to add another criteria, which is very interesting, how to find very rapidly the criticality of services and the criticality of relationships. So criticality of nodes and criticality of links in the requested graph. And taking into account this kind of constraints, we would like to find optimal solutions for this kind of problem. So if this picture gives more details before exploring the solutions of the problem, so we consider here connected graph with some requirements in the edges of this graph, and we would like to find a mapping of this graph onto the larger graph of cloud federation using some quotas in terms of sharing resources, and they have also some hosting costs, and they have also some connectivity costs to be considered. Okay, so if, for example, I summarize the cost of a cloud provider G when hosting some virtual machines or some requests, and when also maybe outsourcing some part of the request to other cloud providers involved in the same federation, so we can finally find this formulation. We also would like to add two parameters, alpha and beta, to characterize when a node, according to alpha, is critical in the point of view of the cloud provider receiving this request, and when an edge is critical for the point of view also of the cloud provider. So we would like to use these inputs. And before investigating a solution or the solutions, that we, because we have two algorithms here to cope with this this problem, so we would like to take a look to the complexity of the problem. And if we simply represent that this is the graph that should be mapped on this largest one, and we can find some similarities to a renowned NP-hard problem, which is the virtual network embedding problem. And unfortunately, our problem so also here is NP-hard. And once again, that's why we would like to investigate efficient solutions to find optimal, near-optimal solutions even for large problem instances. Okay, so let's now start by giving a definition that should be used in our algorithms to detect the criticality of nodes and criticality of edges before investigating the solution of the placement of this kind of requests. We introduce here the Gummy-Rehe transformation, which consists to start from an initial graph, that should be, for example, a full mesh graph, and on each edge of this graph, we have some requirements in terms of connectivity requests, and we apply the Gummy-Rehe transformation to obtain a tree. This first reduces the complexity of the problem to be solved. Instead of considering the placement of this much larger graph, we simply try to find a mapping of this one, which is a tree. And the other hand, if here we consider the parameter alpha, if you remember that alpha is equal to 3, so here, for example, the node 2 is critical for this cloud provider. If we consider that beta is equal to 40, for example, megabit per second, so this edge, this one are critical and should be maybe placed in some way. So the idea of the Gummy-Rehe tree transformation finally consists to find n minus 1, such as n is the number of nodes here in this graph, maximum flow between each couple of nodes. If I would like to know here what's the maximum flow that should be routed from 1 to 5, so I have just here I have to put some computations, but there it's very easy. I have just to take or look to the unique and only one path linking 1 and 5 and take the minimum value on this path to find finally that the maximum flow between nodes 1 and 5 is simply equal to 31, for example. Now, this Gomoro-Hue tree transformation helps us to reduce the complexity of the problem when allowing also at the same time to detect criticality in nodes of nodes and edges. That should be used in our solution. So this is the first contribution. And the second contribution also consists, according to the tree found here, we would like to find an optimal placement of this tree. That's why we are proposing two algorithms. One is based on critical node detection, and the second one is based on critical edge detection. To explain very quickly, but the details are also in the manuscript, how this algorithm works. So suppose that we have a graph and we applied the Gomoro-Hue tree transformation, so we found this Gomoro-Hue tree transformation, right? Now we found also the values on the arcs or on the edges, and if, for example, alpha is equal to 2 here as a simple example, so nodes 1, 2, 3, 4 are critical for this provider and maybe should be hosted within the cloud provider for security reasons, for example. And the other ones, and if the prices proposed by the cloud providers, the other cloud providers involved in the same federation are low, so why not to outsource them? 5 and 6 should be, or maybe, for example, outsourced. The other algorithm is based on the critical edge detection. So first, I have the same example. If beta is equal to 8, so we found that 4, 5, and 2, 6 are edges which are critical for this cloud provider, and maybe it's preferable to host them within the cloud provider and then outsource the remainder of the request to the other cloud providers if also the price is interesting. This is the idea of the second algorithm. Now we would like to assess to compare them and using some metrics. For example, here we define the gap in percentage, which is the distance between the solution found by our algorithm compared to the exact solution found by the branch and bound algorithm. So here we can find that for the CND algorithm, the gaps are high, clearly. So this means that the solution found by the CND algorithm are bad, to be honest. And instead of rejection, even if the rejection rate of this algorithm are very close to zero and the convergence time also in milliseconds are also very close to zero, but the quality of the solution is very bad and compared to the optimal solution. That's why also we try to understand, to assess the CD performance of the algorithm of CD. And we found by the same metrics that the gap when considering, for example, here the worst case, a cloud federation of 10 cloud providers and graph sizes equal to 8 nodes, for example, and we can imagine a connectivity between each edge simulated as 75% to have an edge between each couple of nodes. So the gap or the distance compared to the branch and bound algorithm, even for the worst case here, is very close to zero. This means we are not so far from the optimal solution. So this is, for us, this is a small contribution. And also the rejection rate and the necessary time to converge to the optimal solution are very negligible compared to the branch and bound algorithm, exceeding, for example, here 8 minutes, okay, for this case. We also discussed the scalability, of course, of our algorithms. So we considered the cloud federation, I don't know if this can exist, of 100 cloud providers when taking into account a request with 50 nodes and a connectivity of 75% that an edge can exist. So the CND algorithm of course, they converge very quickly to a solution, not, unfortunately, not the optimal solution, but the CED also, and they have the same rejection rate, which is close to zero, but the cost of the CED algorithm is very negligible compared to the CND algorithm. So if we can summarize very quickly to the concerning this part, the CND algorithm here in our case, when we would like to detect node critictions or edge critictions, for here the approach for detecting edge critical edge, so CND algorithm performs better than the CND approach. To enhance or to improve this solution, because if we look at this this column of the CED, we don't have 0% to say that we found the optimal. So we would like to improve these results by finally taking into account the nodes and the links placement jointly. The problem becomes harder, of course, but we think that we can get something that converges better than the CED. Of course, this is also collaboration with some PhD students who helped me to elaborate this work. Finally, I would like now to consider more complex requests to be placed or on which we would like to find a mapping, an optimal mapping, if it's possible, on a larger graph. So here we are, we would like to address an ITSI NFV use case on which we look for the mapping of a virtualized network functions forwarding graph that should be defined in the SQL, that on a larger graph which is represented by an undirected graph with some metrics that should be also detailed in an optimal manner. So if we take a look very quickly to the documentation of ITSI, so this is a well-known VNF forwarding graph request on which we found a directed graph in graph theory, in which we have three chains, for example, here, soliciting different virtualized network functions. As an example, chain one is soliciting F1, F2, F3, F4, and then terminates. And chain three, for example, is soliciting F1, F2, F5, and then terminates. So we would like to find a mapping for this graph to this one in an optimal manner when reducing the total resource consumption. Now, we start by introducing some metrics to clarify the problem. And we take an example. Here we have a small VNF forwarding graph example, on which we have two chains, one with 5 megabit per second, and the second one is 7 megabit per second. And we have some requirements in terms of CPU cores that should be prepared to run this kind of VNFs. And the chains, SFC, here are, as you can see them in this example, and we would like, when taking into account the same metrics, so we have bandwidth requirement here and availabilities here, and the same metrics on the servers or on the routers, for example, to be considered to finally find an optimal mapping when reducing the total amount resource consumption here. So the problem is MP-hard, unfortunately, because it is very very similar to, once again, to the virtual network embedding problem. And I added also this reference, which is very recent, on which we can find a very complete study of the complexity of the virtual network embedding problem. So if we relax the sequencing constraints here and we consider routers here, so the problem is very similar to the virtual network embedding problem, unfortunately, which is MP-hard. So we would like, once again, to find optimal solutions for this kind of problem in few seconds or in negligible time in general. Okay, so to do that, our proposal is based on two things. So we know that the problem is NP-hard in general, but we would like to investigate some solutions to, maybe there are some polynomial variants of the problem if we relax some constraints. So this is a strong condition. That's why we would like to propose a first approach to solve the problem of VNF forwarding graph chaining and placement problem in an optimal manner or near optimal manner when considering the perfect two-factor approach. that should be detailed in the SQL. For the case in which we have VNF forwarding graphs with only three VNFs, and then propose another solution to generalize the result when for VNF forwarding graphs contains more than four, at least four VNFs in a given sequencing, of course. So let's start by detailing the perfect, I missed the word perfect because we have an equality here. The perfect two-factor approach mathematical formulation is given there. And we would like to start from example. So if I do that, we have a chain, an SFC coming from F1, F2, and F4 with 7 megabits per second, for example. We have just to add a fictitious arc that should not be considered in our optimization. And then instead of looking for where can I find a placement of my chain, really I look for an optimal cycles. And in the other hand, in complexity theory, we know that if we look for cycles in a graph, the problem is easy. In complexity theory, of course. In algorithmic complexity theory. So we use the perfect two-factor mathematical formulation or the convex hull of the perfect two-factor, which is given there. Of course, we have continuous variables. And we, of course, modified something in the objective functions to get some similarities to our problem. Once again, we started from an NP-hard problem. We found a linear reduction to another problem, which is very easy to solve. And we can finally solve the NP-hard problem according to some conditions, of course, to in linear time, in polynomial time. This is the first algorithm when we consider only VNF forwarding graphs with three VNFs. And let me now propose another approach when we consider VNF forwarding graphs with at least three VNFs or four VNFs. It works also for the case in which we have three VNFs, of course. So escape this slide because I would like to explain it directly on this graph. It's much better. So here I take an example, once again, for sake of simplicity, of three VNFs. One, for the first reason, it's the simplicity to expose the algorithm. And the second one consists also to say that the multi-stage graph algorithm should also work even if we take only three VNFs in the VNF forwarding graph. Now, the construction of this multi-stage graph is as follows. I have this example, F1, F2, F3, with requirements of 10 megabit per second. And so I construct some levels. So here we have three VNFs, then we have three levels. And on each level, I select on the first graph, on the physical graph, only the feasible servers in terms of available CPU cores here that can handle, that can host this VNF. So here we can find this kind of servers. And maybe the same servers are also in the other level if they are able to host this VNF and so on. So first, I select the servers which are available to host these VNFs in terms of CPU cores. So this is the first criteria. And now I would like to add arcs in a manner that there is an arc from this node, for example, to this one with a capacity which is equal to the maximum flow in the initial graph between this server and this one. And this maximum flow will be solicited, for example, if it's over than the required amount of bandwidth in this VNF forwarding graph or in this chain. And for example, here, for sake of simplicity, once again, I missed to pull an arc from this server to this one, which is the same server, as you can see. And maybe we have to add an arc here with an infinity capacity to say that we are on the same server. Now, we add two fictitious nodes, S and T, and just we apply a marking process, very simple marking process, to finally try to reach T starting from S or the inverse. The physical servers that should be marked according to some criteria that will be detailed also in the numerical analysis. So they are the servers on which we will deploy effectively the VNFs. And we have also the fact that this amount is over than the requirement. So we finally satisfied the two criteria in one operation. Now, this is the idea to solve the VNF forwarding graph chaining and placement problem. We would like to compare our algorithms to finally discuss their performances. We used first the execution time, the time necessary time to converge to a solution or near optimal solution, for example. So we found that the execution time of the multi-stage graph algorithm is often close to 0 seconds. Compared to the two-factor algorithm, even if it is capped by approximately 0.45 seconds, even for large problem instances, considered in our case, of course. And this can be explained very easily that the multi-stage graph that we constructed before is very sparse. So we don't have an exponential number of cases to be investigated to find the optimal solution or near optimal solution, as we can see it in the sequence. So the second metric is how to evaluate the acceptance ratio of the two algorithms, the two-factor one and the multi-stage graph. So we found that the convex hull of the two-factor problem, the perfect two-factor problem, has an acceptance ratio very close to 1 at the end of the simulation time compared to the multi-stage algorithm, graph algorithm, which on which the acceptance ratio is close to 96%. Here, as you can remark, we have two variants in the choice of the multi-stage graph algorithm. We have a max variant to say that when we are here, so if I would like to detect the first server that should be used to host this VNF, so is this one, is this one, is this one? So we have two criteria, so the max and min. Max to say that we start by the physical available servers with maximum amount of CPU and min, the minimum, the server with the minimum amount of CPU. So we compared. We compared also our works, our algorithms, to some existing work in the literature, which are very close as they deal with the same kind of problem as our problem. So we compared to this reference using a real trace, which is an interrupt network, which is a graph with 100 nodes and 148 edges. And we considered approximately the same kind of request of VNF forwarding graphs. And finally, we found that the acceptance ratio of our algorithms, especially the variant of multi-stage with maximum criteria, is very close to 100% compared to this one. And even if the cost is a little bit larger than the cost found here, and the execution time of this kind of graphs is approximately the same. So we compared to this reference to assess the acceptance ratio and the cost, but also we compared to another reference, which is this one, given here, to compare finally, especially the scalability of our algorithms. When we consider here, for example, a physical network with 200 nodes, so we found that a multi-stage graph algorithm is converging in 0.05 seconds compared to the two-factor 0.45 seconds, which is confirmed by the earlier result. And the most important thing here is that this reference is converging in 1,000 seconds compared to 0.05 seconds. So this is very important for our algorithm, as we can find near optimal solutions in very negligible times compared to the literature. We would like to extend especially the convex hull of the mathematical formulation of the perfect two-factor algorithms, because it seems very efficient, but we would like to add more than four VNFs. We would like to consider more than four VNFs in our graph. So for that, we have investigated new valid inequalities to be included in this convex hull to avoid cycles with sizes lower than 3, for example. And it seems working fine, but actually it's under work. And this is, of course, a collaboration with my PhD student, actually present here, and a postdoctorate from Telecom Sud Paris. This is the end of the research challenge that I would like to share with you today. And please let me now open some research challenges, some of them. Actually, I'm working actually on them when collaborating. So with, for example, on this subject, we try to find some collaborations with DOSIT. And in this problem, this first research challenge consists to find an optimal mapping of the VNF forwarding graph on a larger graph when considering availabilities of servers or nodes, and also with considering into account link failures, for example. So if we would like to find an exact formulation, if it's possible, to solve efficiently this problem. The second research area actually investigated with Professor Ahmed Kamal, and which consists to consider the virtualized content delivery network placement and migration. We would like to use the NFV paradigm to finally find our proposed very efficient solution to migrate very quickly virtualized caches or content from a server to another one, finally to reduce the latency, to reduce the resources of the network, and in an optimal manner, if we can do it. The last research activity, we are working also in collaboration with Orange and Nokia, consists to find an optimal split of some functions of the baseband unit. So actually, we consider cloud radio access network here, and this is an overview of the architecture which is imagined today when connecting remote radio heads using a front hall, and we would like to connect them to a BBU pool of resources, and we would like so to ensure some uplink and downlink operations in an optimal manner. So we are thinking about how to find an optimal splits of some functions, finally to reduce the resources that should be used in the front hall network, when also reduce the latency and also reduce the energy consumption in this pool of PBUs, etc. So this is also actually a work on which we are collaborating with Orange and Nokia, and actually we have some preliminary results which are very promising. This is the all of my presentation. Thanks for your time. And of course, if you have any questions, please give away. Thank you.